My name is Teddy Walsh. I'm originally from Mill Street in Westport, a real Covey, born and bred and reared on Mill Street over the pub. And my father and mother were Coveys before me, so I have a good tradition in Westport.
When did the pub come into your possession?
My grandfather started the pub in 1890, and then my father took over after that, and I did my stint then for, I suppose, near most part of the years. Well, I was sit and drink when I was only a gossamer, 10 or 12 years of age.
And you sold it in?
We sold it in Christmas Eve 1999, we closed down.
1999. So it was in your position for a long time.
It was a long time, in the nearly 100 years, I suppose, you can say, over 100 years.
And when you were a young fellow, how did you spend your time around Westport?
Most of the time we'd be out swimming at the Pint of the Quay. In the summertime we often used to go out and down bikes. And we'd be swimming until maybe the end of October, most years at the Pint. And we had to maybe tag out and down coal shed out there. We often came home dirtier than when we went out. And handball, we had a lot of handball that time. And go to the Christian Mother School at the time, we played the Irish football and that.
Well, then in Castlebar Street, was it?
Castlebar Street, yeah.
Downstairs and upstairs,
downstairs and upstairs. We went to Convent first for a couple of years and then down to the Christian Brothers after that.
That seemed to be the cycle that time. You went to the convent, downstairs and upstairs.
Upstairs, that was it, yeah.
And upstairs was Leaving Cert, up to Leaving Cert.
Up to, seventh class up. And tough times were, I'll tell you one thing.
And how did you spend your nights now? How did you socialise and all that?
Wasn't much socialising at that time, really. You know, you go to the town hall and play a snooker or give a table tennis. That was the go at the time.
That was in the town hall then?
That was in the town hall, yeah. Oh, yeah.
You go to cinema?
Occasionally, yeah. A couple of nights a week, maybe. Depends. Well, two cinemas that time in town, you could have your choice. The picture would be on two nights at a time, Monday and Tuesday, the change Wednesday and Thursday, Friday and Saturday again, Sunday would be different.
And where were the cinemas then?
The cinema was on the actor, you know, where the town hall is now, and GMC, the ideal cinema was.
And who owned the Octagon one?
The priest, I suppose, really owned it. It was run by the church and that, you know, they were in charge of the town hall, you know.
And the other one?
Michael Hoban was the Octagon, I owned the ideal when I was the gossamer.
And had it started before your time? The cinema, the ideal.
Oh, no, it was going, yeah. No. It was a dance hall, they used to do it for dances, so. First dance ever I went to was the Gales dance, and the ideal.
Oh, I never heard that, actually.
That's right.
And were there any other dancing venues over the years then?
Yeah, no, Pavilion came on the scene then. They built up the soccer pitch and that, and then they built the Pavilion down there. And that was the main mecca for dancing then at that time. Soccer pitch was a whole go at that time. Was a big opening down there, the soccer pitch, 1953, for the 1st of June, Everton against the Irish selection.
53?
Midsummer day, 53.
Oh, yes.
I was the wettest day that ever came. And the cause of our factory went on fire the same day.
The same day.
Yeah, it was a small crowd at it. I still have the programme, the official programme, the original programme.
I've seen that.
Yeah,
most of the sponsors of that have gone.
They have, most have gone.
Most have gone, I've seen that. Yeah. It's very interesting.
Yeah. The original programme, and I have the original invitation my father had for it.
And where did you go to the, you went to secondary school then? And
I went to secondary school to Christian Mothers for 3 years. After doing the intercept, then I went to St. Gerard's for 2 years. My brother Charlie was going for 5 years, so I was sent to remind him.
So after that, you done the Leaving Cert, what did you do then?
The Leaving then, I came home after Leaving then, and I started working with James O'Connell across the road in the Cash and Carry, driving an old van for a couple of years, and on over Connemara and Acton and Ballincroy. And
he was a wholesale grocer,
he was a wholesale grocer, yeah. And that's where I met Bernie, in O'Connell's.
In O'Connell's, was she working there too?
She was, yeah.
Oh, okay.
That's right.
And then
we got married in 1969, I think it was, and then I had to give up that. I had to get back into a business in a shed working there.
Into your own pub, is it?
Into the pub, yeah.
Was there much of a change in the pub trade that time, Teddy?
In your time? We didn't look the place in 1950, and it really took off after that. Like, you know, before that, I remember the young fella coming into the pub, like, and that time it was, you know, there was flag floor and that kind of carry on, you know. Yeah. We jumped up that time, Cox did up for that time in 1950. And after that, our business took off, like, and we did well. We had a good old living out.
And did you have a grocery thing?
We had a grocery at the front, yeah. Bear and grocery, yeah. That was the style at the time, like, you know. And the same people dealt with you all their lives, like, you know.
You kept a little bit of grocery all the time, didn't you?
We did, yeah.
Like it wasn't overstocked in the beginning?
No. We had enough, like, to keep going. You had essentials, the fella said, like, and that, you know.
The fella would be going out and he'd want a pound of butter and a loaf of bread.
And then he used to come to town for a loaf, maybe, or something like that. Oh, yeah. We had a lot, there was a great hell of fun in the old times of the public, you know. You'd always have a few fellas in there to be around sing song at night time, you know. John McKinnon out there on the mission was a great old singer. He'd seen the Road to Dundee and Isle of Finnish Free and a few of these ones, you know, and a few more canisters. Jerry Kelly was down to see Gabriel's father, was a great old cat. He'd always given out their first song and a few more for us. Paddy Welsh led an uncle, Michael Derrick. He'd be a grand uncle now with the Welshes that play rugby. There was a fella singing in one night, anyway, I think it was a great old singer. And he finished, anyway, he said to me, he said, "I don't blame you at all," he said, "but show me the who the rest of the sing."
Did you ever have to talk to guys in pubs?
I had to talk to an odd fella, right, and advise him, like, it's a better thing to keep it closed or disappear. You know, I always figured out that fellas came in for a few pints for peace and ease, maybe after leaving noise at home, and they wanted to be the peace and ease, or better have a quiet house and have the mountain.
So you left them alone nice and quiet?
Well, yeah. Most of the time we had no problem in the world, yeah. There were some round skins, you know.